completed my B.Tech.
So, Toastmasters, you have heard of two states?
Yes.
Seen it? Seen it?
Yes.
Very good. Some I have also read it. Let me tell you about two greats. Last week was a phenomenal week for India, but there was also two buoyants of Indian business icons who passed on. They were great people. But to be honest, I mean, they started out as ordinary people like us, but they went on to become great and left their footprints in the sands of time. Any guesses who I'm talking about?
Modi.
Rossi Modi and Captain Krishna Nair. Let me start with Captain Krishna Nair. Captain Krishna Nair started out as a cadet in the Indian National Army under Subhash Chandra Bose. He wanted to grow in this profession. Later on, when India had gained independence, he joined the Indian Army as in the Maharashtra Infantry. But Leela had different plans. Leela happened to be his wife. And his wife wanted him to join her family business, which is textile handloom. Now, Krishna Nair was very keen on growing up in the army. And he was in a dilemma. So he went and approached his senior. And the senior gave him a very unique advice. The senior said, see Krishna, in the army, you will grow up in ranks and finally you might even reach the top rank, but then what? But if you take the path which has been envisaged by your wife, sky is the limit. And Krishna decided to join the business. And the business was not going on that great. But over the next two decades, the 20 years, he took Leela Lace, that is the name of the organization, Leela Lace, to one of the largest export houses in India. In fact, Leela Lace is credited with coming up with a very famous fabric which was a hit worldwide. It was called the Bleeding Madras fabric. It was even shot, some movies were even focused with that kind of fabric and it was worn by the characters. So that was Krishna Nair. In 20 years, he became famous, he had success, everything. Then he decided that it was time to quit. He decided to take sannyas. And he went to the Himalayas. And there he met Swami Sivananda. Swami Sivananda told him, Captain Krishna, you are not exactly cut out to be a sannyasi. See, you want to serve people, you stay in your business. You can serve a lot more people. So Krishna Nair was back and his business flourished. At the age of 60, he started the hospitality. He entered the hospitality line. We know Krishna Nair as the hotel chain, by the Leela hotel chain. So at the age of 60, he started with his first hotel in Bombay. And now these hotels are premium hotels all over the world. The inspiration behind this hotel was he was globetrotting as the chairman of his textile company. He was globetrotting and he had stayed in many fantastic hotels. So he thought, why not get the best of the best hospitality which is available worldwide and club it with an Indian essence. That was the move behind the hotel chain. And somebody asked him, how come you name your hotel chain as Leela, Hotel Leela? He said, with a glint in his eyes, Leela is worth it. So that was Captain Krishna Nair. In fact, recently as a tribute, when Vijay Amritra, the tennis icon, gave a tribute on him, he said, Captain Krishna Nair had such an amazing zest for life, that whenever somebody met him, he was totally energized. Moving from Captain Krishna Nair, who the papers called him as an officer and a gentleman, let's move to Rusi Rustamji Hormozji Modi. Rustamji Hormozji Modi or Rusi Modi, born on 17th Jan 1918, joined the Tata Steel at the age of 19 as an office boy. And over the next 30 years, he grew to be the chairman of Tata Steel. He was, as a chairman, he was the chairman for nearly 10 years, a decade, and during this decade, Tata Steel grew from an 8 lakh ton capacity of steel production to over 30 lakh tons capacity. And that was the time when Tata Steel got the name, "We also make steel," the tagline. And Rusi Modi used to be referred as the man of steel. In fact, Rusi Modi had an unmatched ability to deal with people. Fantastic ability to deal with people. And in fact, the SORI, the business school, had a case study, a 2 years case study on Rusi Modi's management style. There's an interesting story. Once, when Rusi Modi was in Jamshedpur, was going somewhere in his car, he was heralded by the Jharkhand Mukti Morcha, quite a militant lot. His security man got panicked, and immediately Rusi Modi got out from the car and went and spoke to them and said, "See, if you want to discuss something, come to my office, we will discuss." And come at a convenient time in a smaller group, and the group dispersed. That was one instance where he tackled, that was his philosophy. He tackled things head on, but he also dealt with people at their level. A very interesting incidence is that of a crane driver in Tata Steel who was once dismissed, and Rusi Modi came to know all. At that time, Rusi Modi was a managing director. He spoke to him and found out, and then he asked for his papers. He asked his HR to give the papers, his, you know, occupation papers. He found out that this guy, this crane driver, had an impeccable track record. Immediately he overruled the dismissal and reinstated him against objections, and when he was asked, he said, "An efficient employee is much, much more costly." This crane driver was dismissed because of he had broken down and broken an equipment. "An efficient employee is much, much more costly than an employee." So that was Rusi Modi's point. He had to leave Tata Steel because of some reasons, and the last 2 decades he was mostly in Calcutta. A couple of years back, somebody reporter spoke to him, "What do you do now?" He replied, "I am sauntering through life, trying to be as polite and as graceful as possible till my call comes." He passed away on 17th May 2014. India will mourn these people. A lot of people will miss them dearly. But let me put it this way, we will all celebrate the lives of both Krishna Nair and Rusi Modi. I'll end this with a small quote by Henry Wadsworth Longfellow, who said, "Lives of great men help remind us that we too can live a life sublime, and in departing, leave behind us footprints in the sands of time." Let me welcome you now, our table topic master, our toastmaster for the day. He is an energetic, gregarious person, works with GE and has an experience of over 10 years in the corporate. He likes to spend time with his young daughter, and he likes to socialize a lot, being part of clubs like JC's and doing a lot of social work. Let me welcome you. Let me help me welcome Shreyans Gandhi. Please put a hand together.